Hello, Adam Rayner here for Talk Audio TV, proud to be sponsored by Sony. That's the magic word, IMAX. You're thinking, what's he looking at? Well, I can reveal that I am very excited today because I'm actually at the IMAX cinema in Uxbridge. We came here after a grim experience at another company's cinema, and, well, we checked out the Avengers Assemble in IMAX. And I do remember IMAX of old. It was always awesome, but this particular installation is a brand new digital one. And it's pancake flat and tight as a duck's bottom, down to 20 cycles. Each of those little enclosures you can see, like sort of spots all around the walls. I've got a large transducer in it, and there's a horn behind that grill as well. I had a little feel. The three windows you can see up there, well, one of them is for inspection, but the other two, actually, let's have a little zoom in on the other two. The other two are, of course, where the IMAX projectors live. These are mighty pieces of ordnance. It's going to get a bit dark as we get in close. Now, I think that's all we can see, but between them, you can just about see the logos, but between them there is an optician's grade camera, the sort used for checking out people's retinas, which looks at the screen behind us, which we're going to turn around and see in a mo. If there's any degradation in image quality whatsoever for any reason, the system talks to headquarters via computer link. Now, the word IMAX we started on was on a full range enclosure. There's another one up in the corner there. You can see the box with the horns in. Cunningly shaped to make sure the high frequencies are evenly spread such that you'd still get locational cues no matter where you're sat in the audience. Lots and lots and lots of side speakers, but if we turn around, just accelerate a little bit, the mighty, mighty IMAX screen. Look at this. It's just, it's going to take up the entire field of view here. Bam. Now, I've been behind that. It's as dark as inside of a cow. But I'm going to attempt to fit my video light on, so no idea quite how that's going to work out. But we're going to go in there and check out, in particular, the sub-bass enclosures. So there's a complete rotation of the Uxbridge IMAX. This is one experience that you simply cannot reproduce at home, even if, like one chap in the Cotswolds I went to visit, you have spent £1 million sterling. Oh, God, I'd love a free pass to here and one of those things that Captain Kirk uses, beam me up, Scotty, IMAX for the evening. Wonderful. Might as well fantasise. Adam Rayner signing out for time being for Talk Audio TV. We're going to go and look behind the screen. Privileged access. Hello, and welcome back in Blair Witch Vision, because I've got my light hooked up now. All part of the lovely kit that Sony sorted us out for their sponsorship. I'm behind the screen. Behind the screen in the IMAX. And the thing I've been itching to see so badly ever since I came to see Avengers Assemble here is sub-bass. I got onto the PR guys. They put me in touch with the Americans. They very kindly gave me 3/4 of an hour of their time and told me all about these enclosures here, which there's 4 12s in each. I'm not sure how many watts is up each one. I don't think it's an enormous number. These are slot ported boxes and they're made specially for IMAX. They're not particularly ornamental, they've just got fuzzy cloth on because they're not for looking at. But over here is the bit that gives me the excitement. It's a magic word, IMAX. Look at that. But over in the corner is one of the older types of enclosures. The light doesn't reach over there. In fact, let's have a little trog through the darkness behind the screen. Here we go, carefully stepping over all the ironmongery. They used to use 18-inch transducers in here, and there is one box left in the corner. I spotted this in the darkness. Check that out. In the meanwhile, of course, the whole place is treated acoustically back here. There's this enormous fat sausage, which, this is a bass trap. It's about keeping control of all of the stray boom frequencies that might be floating about. But if I point the light up in here, just see the light disappearing into the darkness. There's this enormous void with a bit of dust floating around. Hang on, let's get around here again. So the might of the IMAX screen. Up here, one of the enclosures. Reaching all the way up, you can just about make out the passive technology in there. There's some really serious transducer stuff going on. Sorry about the shaky camera, that's my shoulder wobbling. Backstage at IMAX, the most amazing experience you can have in the cinema, something you simply can't do at home. And most importantly, flat to 23 hertz, -3 point is actually only 20 cycles, because the sub-bass enclosures like that one, or the one we just saw. Ooh, Adam Rayner, getting excited about extreme audio as ever and signing out for Talk Audio TV.